Father, we come before you in the name of the Lord Jesus.
天父，我们奉耶稣基督的名来到你面前。
Father, we love your leadership.
父神，我们爱你的带领。
We love your wisdom.
我们爱你的智慧。
Who could plan?
谁能计划
the history of the human race like you have?
人类的历史长河像你这样般计划。
That it would end up with a mature bride at the end of natural history.
你在人类自然的历史当中预备一个成熟的心腹。
Dwelling in love as an international family of affection.
你与我们这个国际爱的家同住。
We thank you for your wisdom.
我们感谢你的智慧。
In Jesus' name, amen.
奉耶稣的名祷告，阿门。
Well, session three.
第三堂。
I call this the convincing power of heroic love.
我称之为英勇的爱有说服人心的能力。
That God is going to awaken heroic love in the body of Christ across the earth.
神要在全地的基督肢体当中唤醒这样英勇的爱。
And I'll define that in a few moments.
我等一下会来定义。
And it's going to convince a billion unbelievers that God is real.
会说服数十亿的未信徒让他们看见神。
Or more than a billion.
甚至超过数十亿。
Let's look at John chapter 15.
我们来看约翰福音十五章。
Verse 12 and 13.
十二节到十三节。
He says, "This is my commandment that you love one another."
这是我的命令，就是你们彼此相爱。
As I have loved you, that's the key phrase.
像我爱你们一样，这是关键。
Then he describes it in verse 13.
然后他在十三节里面描述。
We looked at this at session one last night.
我们第一课昨晚有看到。
Greater love has no one than this.
爱心没有比这更大的。
Then they lay their life down for their friends.
就是人为朋友舍命。
Now Jesus is giving his keen insight into the human dynamics.
耶稣给我们人类关系当中一个关键的看见。
He is saying, "I know what moves humans more than anything."
他说我知道没有什么比这个更能触动人心的。
When they see sacrificial love, something happens in the heart of a human being.
就是当人看见这种牺牲的爱，人的心就会有一个前所未有的震动。
Both believers and unbelievers are moved when they see sacrificial love.
不管是信徒还是非信徒，当他们看见牺牲的爱，就会触动。
Ultimate expression of it,
这个最终的表达
is when a person lays their life down.
就是人为人其他的人舍下生命。
And of course, Jesus was going to do that the very next day.
当然，这后面一天耶稣就如此行了。
And he was letting them know that very moment.
那这一刻，耶稣再让门徒知道
that when he would die the next day.
第二天，当他要上十架
it wasn't because the devil won or defeated him.
不是因为仇敌赢了。
That he offered himself voluntarily for love to rescue our lives.
而是耶稣自发自愿的献上自己的生命，为了赢回我们。
He says, "I'm going to inspire that same heroic love in you for other people."
耶稣说，我要用此来唤醒你里面同样的这样英勇的爱，来唤醒别人。
Look at paragraph C.
我们看 C 点。
In John 13,
约翰福音的十三章。
It's the very same evening.
是同样一个晚上。
John 13 to 17 is all happening at the evening of the Last Supper.
约翰福音十三章到十七章都发生在最后的晚餐那一晚。
These five chapters.
这五章。
I call it the greatest teaching of the greatest teacher in human history.
我称之为人类历史上最伟大的教师的最伟大的教导。
John 13 to 17.
约翰福音十三章到十七章。
I believe the Holy Spirit is going to really emphasize these five chapters in the end time church.
我相信圣灵要在末世的教会当中特别强调这一个教导。
In chapter 13, verse 34,
约翰福音十三章三十四节
he had just washed the disciples' feet.
他就刚刚洗完了门徒的脚。
They've just finished their last supper meal together and had communion.
他们刚刚领完了圣餐，享受完最后的晚餐。
Then verse 34,
三十四节说
he says, "A new commandment I give you."
他说我赐给你们一条新命令
that you love one another.
乃是叫你们彼此相爱
in the same intensity that I love you.
用同样我爱你们的方式
Verse 35.
三十五节
When you do this,
你这样做的时候
multitudes of people will recognize
众人就会认出
that you are followers of Jesus of Nazareth.
你们就是拿撒勒的耶稣的门徒了
If you love in this way,
如果你这样的去爱
Now, in what sense is this a new commandment?
那这怎么样是一个新的诫命呢？
Because it's clear from many scriptures in the Old Testament.
因为在旧约当中也很多经文当中有。
That God commanded people to love one another.
就是神命令百姓彼此相爱。
Leviticus 19 verse 18, he told Moses, tell them to love one another.
摩西出埃及记十九章里面跟摩西说，你要让他们彼此相爱。
About 18 months earlier in the Sermon on the Mount,
在登山宝训十九个月之前
in Matthew chapter 5 verse 44,
约翰福音
Matthew 5 verse 44,
马太福音的第五章44节
I don't have those verses in the notes.
这个经文不在这讲义里
But he said, "Love one another."
他说你要爱人，彼此相爱
So in verse 34,
所以在这里呢，三十四节
In what sense is this new?
这怎么是一条新命令呢
Because he's going to escalate the command to another level.
因为他要让这个命令进到一个新的层面
He had never mentioned loving one another at the level of dying for other people.
因为在此之前从来没有讲到你要爱人以至于献上生命
But this is where he introduces it.
但是这里呢就讲到这个概念
He says the new commandment.
所以说这是新命令
Is that you love in the intensity that I love, and I'm going to die for you tomorrow.
你要用我爱你的方式去爱人，因为我明天要为你死了。
And when the body of Christ embraces this,
当基督的肢体拥抱这个真理。
Verse 35,
35节说
multitudes are going to be impacted by watching this heroic love.
众人就会看见被影响，认出这个英勇的爱。
And they're going to ask questions.
他们会问问题。
Why would they die for someone?
他们为什么会为别人舍命
Why were they not afraid?
他们为什么不害怕
How did they get, where did they get their boldness?
他们哪来的勇气啊
What's the goal of them? What's the result of them dying for other people?
他们为别人死是目标是什么
In the end time church,
在末世的教会
when the great persecution increases, which it's going to,
当大逼迫临到增长的时候
it's going to change the conversation of the entire human race.
会改变整个人类历史的对话
They're all going to be asking questions. Why did they do it? How did they do it? What's the goal for this?
他们都会彼此问说为什么他们要这样做他们的目的是什么
And even, over a billion unbelievers will look at this and say this is the example of Jesus of Nazareth
那数十亿的未信徒都会看见说哇原来这就是拿撒勒人耶稣的门徒
Jesus was actually giving an end time prophecy right here in verse 35
在这里三十五节耶稣其实是给了一个末世的预言
Now of course this has been partially fulfilled for 2,000 years wherever there's been martyrdom
当然在过去两千年凡是有殉道的时候都有部分的实现。
But the great hour of martyrdom is those years leading up to the coming of the Lord.
但是最大的那殉道将要在主再来的日子之前发生。
And that martyrdom is in the plan of God.
这殉道是在神的计划当中的。
It's going to glorify the church.
是要荣耀教会。
Transform the church.
更新教会。
Unify the church.
合一教会。
Bring in a billion souls of unbelievers.
把更多数十亿的信人带信主
Many, many positive things are going to happen in the result of the great end time persecution.
在末后的大灾难发生的时候，会有很多这样正面的事情发生。
The issue of blood magnifies the reality of love.
这个流血的事是将爱升华到了极致。
When blood is involved, it's like a megaphone.
当流血的事件发生，就好像一个放大镜。
It makes people stop and turn their attention and ask deep questions and to be awestruck by what just happened.
就会让人停下来，转向他们的注意力去问问题，让他们被震惊。
Paragraph D.
第一点。
Don't lose the power of these words. All will know.
你不要错过这一个词叫做众人都看见。
Billions of people will understand the end time church that they're followers of Jesus.
数十亿的人都将要认出他们是耶稣的门徒。
These people displaying heroic love will be clearly defined as his disciples.
这些人会展现出这样英勇的爱，让人们看见他们是耶稣的门徒。
The only group of people on the earth that are totally fearless in the face of death.
只有这一群人在地上最终会完全勇敢无畏。
The book of Revelation 12 verse 11
在启示录十二章十一节
says that the end time disciples they do not love their life even in the face of death.
说门徒 在地上末后的日子，门徒不怕死亡。
Because they've understood Jesus is the resurrection.
因为他们知道耶稣就是复活的主。
They will see themselves as sons of the resurrection, as Jesus said.
他们看见自己就是那复活的儿子，就如同耶稣说的。
Now when it says all will know,
当这里说众人都要看见
，it doesn't mean everybody will get converted because they observe it.
不是指说每个人看见就一定会变成得救。
Some will become angry at the boldness and the heroic love of the end-time church.
有人看见的反倒会被这末世的勇敢的信徒所冒犯。
Others will be deeply provoked and inspired by it.
另外一些人呢是深深的被触动并且得救。
Some will be confused by it.
有的人会很困惑。
But all will know that they are people that are loyal followers of Jesus.
但是众人都要看见并且知道他们是耶稣忠心的门徒。
Roman number two.
第二大点。
Jesus prophesied a time of unprecedented carnage.
耶稣预言到一个这个死亡的人数会空前的增加。
Unprecedented bloodshed.
史无前例的流血。
And we need to understand this even in these early days.
我们现在就要来明白这些。
Because it's actually the hour of the greatest glory of God in the church of all of history.
因为这也是神给教会应许的最荣耀的时刻。
But without a biblical understanding, it looks like the most terrible time of church history.
但是如果没有按照真理来明白的时候，好像看见教会这是最惨的时刻。
I believe we're entering a time frame globally.
我们相信全球教会都进入到这个时刻。
Where the body of Christ must understand the biblical narrative of end-time persecution.
基督的肢体必须按照圣经来明白末后的逼迫。
They must understand the glory and the benefits of the end-time persecution.
他们要来明白这末后的逼大灾难的荣耀跟奖赏。
Now, obviously, places like the underground church in China have experienced this for a decade. I mean, for a generation.
当然，我们相信在中国的地下教会，他们所经历数十年。
And in places like this,
流血的那些地方，逼迫的地方。
But it's about to come to the entire body of Christ in the earth.
但这将要临到全地的基督肢体。
Persecution is coming to the Western church.
逼迫将要临到西方的教会。
And most believers are not prepared. They're not thinking about it.
大多数的信徒没有预备好，他们都不。
And the way we get prepared for it,
我们怎么样预备？
One way is by understanding the biblical narrative, the benefits and the reasons for it.
其中一个方式就是按照圣经来明白逼迫的益处跟它的荣耀。
Paragraph A.
A 点。
In Matthew 24,
在马太福音二十四章
this was on Tuesday of the of Jesus's final week.
在耶稣在地上最后一个礼拜的礼拜二
the Last Supper was Thursday.
最后的晚餐在周四
and then he dies on Friday.
然后周五的时候他上十架
so on Tuesday,
所以在周二时
he gave them an interpretive grid for understanding the end times.
他给了我们一个明白末世的一个解读大纲。
He says in Matthew 24,
他在马太福音二十四章说
I want you to understand these different types of pressures.
我要让你知道末世将发生的压迫。
I want you to see it's going to lead to a harvest in all the nations.
我要让你看见这将带出列国的灵魂收割。
I want you to be aware it will be a time of bloodshed like never ever in history.
我要让你知道这是史无前例的流血。
And I want you to be aware that I will be appearing in the sky soon after that to transfer, I mean to transition the earth to the age to come.
我也要让你知道，我将从天空降临，将这地带到一个新的时节。
He said in verse 21.
在二十一节说。
At that time.
在那时。
The final 3.5 years of natural history.
在人类历史的最后三年半。
Will be a time of great tribulation never seen in history before.
那时必有大灾难，是史无前例的。
And here's the verse 22.
二十二节说。
Unless those days were shortened,
若不减少那日子
because they're limited to 42 months, 3.5 years.
因为局限在四十二个月，就是三年半的时间。
No flesh would have survived this if it went on for 30 or 40 years.
凡有血气的，没有一个人能得救。如果超过四十二个月的话
when it says no flesh would be saved,
他说凡有血气的
he means nobody would physically survive this. If it lasted 42 years instead of 42 months.
如果是这个大灾难超过四十二个月，如果是四十二年的话，没有一个人在身体上面能够得救。
Paragraph B.
B 点
This time of great trouble.
这 大灾难的日子
is the context for displaying extravagant love to the nations of the earth.
就是教会向全地展现这个不计代价的爱的一个平台。
The billions in the earth will have an eyewitness account of extravagant love that flows from God's heart.
地上数十亿的人都要看见这些百姓彰显出神的那个不计代价的爱。
There will be many facets of crisis in society.
在社会当中要看到很多的危机出现。
From food shortages,
有食物短缺
crisis created by earthquakes, tsunamis,
地震海啸引发的灾难
suffering, human traffic, and murder, and demon worship,
贩卖人口拜偶像拜假神
persecution, martyrdom of Christians and Jews,
逼迫基督徒犹太人殉道
Jesus highlighted all of these things on Tuesday before he talked about extravagant love on Thursday.
耶稣在礼拜二强调这些困难之后在周四的时候他讲到逼迫
And now he's talking on Thursday, John 15.
他在约翰福音十五章里面就是周四
The passage we're in now.
我们之前讲的
About greater love, extravagant love. No one's ever seen anything like this before.
他就讲到这付极大代价的爱是没有人见过的
Page 11.
11页
I want to talk about the unique power of bloodshed.
我要讲舍身流血的独特的能力
Bloodshed has a unique impact on the human psyche, on the human heart.
舍身流血会给人的心有一个特别的震动
And bloodshed has a very prominent place in God's end time plans.
舍身流血也在神的计划当中有一个不可取代的地位。
Because bloodshed grabs the attention of the human heart like nothing else does.
因为流血的事件比任何一个事件更能抓住人心。
Bloodshed magnifies love as well as hatred like nothing else does.
它也比任何一个东西更能够放大爱或者是仇恨。
And Jesus wants us to know 2,000 years ago.
那两千年前，耶稣就想让我们知道。
It is in the plan of God, and it's going to result in John 17 unity of the international church.
这是神计划的一部分，也会带出一个约翰福音十七章里面讲到合一的教会。
Lord says, "I know what I'm doing with this."
耶稣说，我知道我在做什么。
The end time church will actually understand this more and more the closer we get to the increase of this.
当我们更多看见这些事件发生的时候，就更多能。
Paragraph A.
A 点
The shedding of blood is offensive.
舍身流血令人很不安
I mean, it troubles all of us.
是让我们都有这种不安感
But it has the most powerful social impact on humans because it's so costly.
但是对人呢，又有最大的社会影响力，因为这是付最大代价的
It magnifies love like nothing else does.
它比任何其他的东西都能更大的放大爱。
The laying down of our life for love will be one of the most powerful weapons in the end time church.
为爱的缘故而舍下生命是末世最大的武器。
Weapons against the kingdom of darkness.
是抵挡黑暗国度的最大的武器。
There's nothing Satan can do if you're not afraid of death.
当你连死都不怕的时候，仇敌不能把你怎么样。
He will kill, and every time he kills, it magnifies the glory of God to the society.
他会努力去杀害，但是当你舍身的时候，会更大的荣耀神的国度。
He will be so frustrated.
这个魔鬼会非常的愤怒。
The more he kills, the more people see extravagant love, and they want to be a part of it.
他更多杀害的时候，就更多展现出神的爱和荣耀，更多人想
要。The more he kills, the more believers get emboldened in love, and they become fearless of death.
当他更多去杀害的时候，就有更多的信徒能够展现出英勇的爱，就有更多的人被此折服。
This is a big subject that's big.Bigger than our message today.
这也是比我们今天讲的要更大的一个主题。
But I want to point it out.
但我想要指出来这一点。
Because I believe in the next 10, 20, 30 years.
因为我相信在未来的十年、二十年、三十年。
This topic must be talked about many, many times in a very deep level all over the earth.
这个主题要在全地很多的教会、很多的层面更多的去讲解。
Paragraph B.
B 点。
In the scripture,
在圣经中
blood is an emblem of life.
血乃是生命的象征。
It has there's a mysterious power to blood.
血有一个非常奥秘的实际。
It says in Deuteronomy, life is in the blood.
生命记里面讲到说，血是在生命里面。
When Cain killed his brother Abel,
当该隐杀害了他弟兄亚伯。
Abel's blood had a voice.
亚伯的血有一个声音发出。
It has an impact that cries out to God.
有一个影响力是向神发出呼求。
There's a mysterious power when blood is shed.
当流血发生的时候，有一个奥秘的力量。
Paragraph C.
C 点。
There will be unprecedented bloodshed at the end of the age.
在末世必有空前的大规模流血。
I mean the final 42 months.
就是那最后的42个月。
This is not an accident where God is failing in his leadership.
这不是一个意外的事件，好像神没有办法掌控了。
But it's a necessity that God understands.
而是这是神的计划当中必要的发生的事。
It will openly display the love of God to the nations in a way opposite of what Satan is planning.
这将公开的展现出神他的爱和能力是完全是跟仇敌所计划的是抗衡的。
Revelation chapter 6.
启示录第六章
verse 9,
第九节
John saw the martyrs under the altar.
约翰看见那坛底下被杀之人
The altar of heaven, they were there. He saw the end time martyrs.
那在天上就是他看见那些殉道者
And it was said to these martyrs in the end times,
他在对这些末世的殉道者说
Rest until the final number of martyrs is completed.
你要等候安息片时直到那些被杀的数目满足
That's an interesting idea.
这个是很有趣的概念
I'll mention three different metrics that are a part of God's end time plan.
我要描述神的末世计划当中三个很独特的部分
All the nations have to hear the gospel preached.
列国所有的国家都要听到福音
That's one metric.
这是第一个
All 200 nations have to hear the gospel preached in power before the end.
在末后末世之前，两百多个国家都要听到神的福音。
There's a certain number of martyrs that God has ordained.
神也定义了一个殉道的数目。
And in Revelation 5, the bowls of prayer are filled around the throne.
启示录的第五章讲到说，宝座前的这个金香炉也要被盛满。
So there's a certain amount of prayer that goes forth.
所以也要有一定的祷告升起。
There's several other metrics in God's end time plans.
在神末世的计划当中，也有几个其他。
But those are three of them that go together.
但这三个是彼此相连的。
Revelation 17.
启示录十七章。
The harlot Babylon.
大淫妇巴比伦。
That's this worldwide religion inspired by Satan and the Antichrist.
这是撒旦跟敌基督所兴起的一个全球性的一个系统。
They will be drunk with the blood of the saints.
他们要喝醉了圣徒的血。
That means they will be intoxicated and emboldened to kill. The more they kill, the bolder they get to kill.
意思就是他们好像杀人上瘾，更多的去杀害，就更多的想要去杀害圣徒。
The more they kill, the more intoxicated and frenzied they are to kill more.
他们更多的去杀害，就更想要去迫害圣徒。
The more they kill, they will have bloodlust that will be inspired by demons to kill more.
他们如同嗜血的魔鬼一样，就更多的想要去杀害圣徒。
Paragraph D.
D 点。
The subject of Christians and of Jews enduring persecution is an end time reality.
这是又严肃又真实的，就是在末后必有信徒跟以色列人受逼迫。
It's a sober reality.
这是一个让人清醒的实际。
But it has a glorious result to it.
但是却有一个荣耀的结果。
But it's repeated so often in prophetic scriptures.
但在先知性的经文里面有多很多很多提到。
It's impossible to miss it if you read the Bible with an open heart.
如果你打开的心去读圣经的时候，你不可能错过的。
Most believers are almost completely unaware of this.
大多数的信徒甚至完全不明白。
I mean, they know a little bit. This one verse here, this one verse there. They have no idea how important this is in God's end time plan.
可能很多人看到这里有一点，那里有一点，却不明白这对神的末世计划有多么的重要。
Roman numeral 4.
第四大点。
The apostles came to understand the benefit and the privilege of persecution.
使徒们他们明白来受苦遭逼迫是多么的荣幸跟荣耀。
Their perspective was transformed.
他们的眼光被改变了。
They saw it as a gift that God allowed them to have.
他们视它为是一个神所给他们的一个礼物，一个恩赐。
In a short amount of time,
在很快的时候
in a matter of months,
在不到几个月
they went from fleeing from Jesus when Jesus was arrested in fear,
他们从耶稣受难的时候，他们逃跑
to seeing persecution as a gift and a benefit and a blessing to their life.
转化到看受逼迫是一个恩赐，是祝福，是礼物。
So much so that they rejoiced in it.
他们如此的改变，让他们领受了这个喜乐。
Because they saw the value of it to their own life.
因为他们很珍视这一点，不惜付上生命的代价。
We'll talk a little bit more about that in some of the future sessions in this conference here.
我们在未来的几堂里面会更多讲到这个主题。
Paragraph top of page 12.
十二页的最上面。
Paragraph B.
B 点。
Paul said, "I consider the sufferings of this life."
保罗说，我看现在的苦楚
not worthy to be compared with the glory I'm going to receive related to the suffering.
比起将来我要得着的荣耀，就完全不足介意了。
And the sufferings here
在这里的苦
is related to persecution. This isn't meaning financial bankruptcy or physical sickness. That's not what he's talking about.
这个受苦是指的是逼迫，而不是我们身体上生病或者是没钱。
Those sufferings are real.
那些苦楚也是真的。
Suffering of war and hurricanes, those are real.
在飓风、在地震里面的受苦。
But he's talking here specifically persecution.
但是这里他讲的是逼迫。
Standing in loyal love in the place of your because they hate Jesus.
在受苦被逼迫被因为别人恨耶稣，在那个里面也要忠心。
What did Paul understand that made him see that it was not comparable to the glory he would get?
保罗到底是看见了什么，让他说这比起那荣耀就完全不足介意呢
？I have said, Lord, let me see what Paul saw, and I could be committed like Paul was committed.
我就跟主说，主啊，你让我看见保罗看。就让我可以像他这样来委身。
And the Lord is really going to release a spirit of revelation on the end time church about this subject.
我相信神也在末世的教会一定会释放这样的启示。
Right now we hear it, we go, oh no, no, no.
现在我们看到这个经文就要好害怕哦，不要不要。
We feel fearful anticipating it.
我们就觉得很害怕，不敢去专注。
But I have the testimony of history and of the Bible.
但是我们有历史当中很多的见证，还有圣经的见证。
When it actually happens, it will be surprising.Surprising the spirit of glory that will be involved in it.
但这真的发生的时候，这荣耀也是超过我们想象的。
Jesus said in Luke 6.
因为耶稣在路加福音六章里面讲。
When they hate you,
当人们恨恶你们
，leap for joy.
你要欢喜跳跃。
The benefit that will come to your life for billions of years will surprise you.
在那。幕后的永恒的数十亿年头当中，给你的喜悦是超过你想象的。
Paragraph C.
C 点。
Peter went on to talk about this in detail in 1 Peter.
彼得在彼得前书里面很具体的去讲到。
1 Peter is the five chapters.
彼得前书的那五章。
Is the most detailed presentation of persecution and how to understand it.
是关乎末世的逼迫，我们怎么样明白最具体的描述。
I just want you to note that.
我要让你知道。
I believe that the Lord's going to release understanding of 1 Peter to the end time church in a way we don't understand right now.
我相信神要赐下一个前所未有的明白和启示，关于彼得前书的这五章。
I mean, the whole five chapters, that's the main subject.
这五章的就是这一个主题。
Not the only subject, but it's the main one.
不是唯一的，而是一个主要的主题。
He says, verse 12.
他在十二节说。
He said, beloved.
他说，亲爱的弟兄啊。
1 Peter 4, verse 12.
彼得前书四章十二节。
Don't think.Something strange is happening because you're experiencing persecution.
如果你经历这些逼迫呢，不要以为奇怪。
He goes, "Don't think it's strange and odd that God is using this to test you."
他说你不要觉得神用这样的方式来试验你是很奇怪的事。
He says, "This is in God's plan, and He's going to surprise you of how He will help you."
他说这是神计划的一部分，你会很惊讶的发现神怎么样帮助你。
But instead of being surprised and thinking, "How dare you, God, let this happen to me?"
他说你不要奇怪，好像跟神说，主啊，你怎么能这样对我呢
？Verse 13.
十三节说。
But rejoice.
你要欢喜。
Because you get to be in partnership with Jesus in His suffering.
因为你是同基督一同受苦。
Because Jesus suffered so that the Father's glory would advance across the earth.
因为基督的受苦让神的荣耀可以彰显在全地。
And we saw in John 15, Jesus said, "If you join me in this mandate to see the Father's glory across the earth."
我们也在约翰福音十五章看到耶稣邀请我们说，如果你跟我一样让父神与在我与我一起受苦
，You'll be a partner with me in this.Thing that's the dearest thing to me.
你会跟我一起同工，这对于我来说是最最我最亲爱的一个主题。
In John 15 verse 14, he called it friendship.
约翰福音十五章十四节讲说，这就是与神为友。
Here Peter's talking about it like partnership.
彼得在这里讲到的方式好像与主同工。
He says because his glory is revealed, when his glory is revealed, you will rejoice with great joy.
他说当神的荣耀显现的时候，你就会欢喜快乐。
But here's the important verse I want you to see.
那我要让你看见这个经文很重要。
Verse 14.
十四节。
When this persecution comes,
当这个逼迫发生。
You're blessed in a way you don't understand before it comes.
你是有福的，甚至在那个逼迫发生之前。
You may not understand it when it first begins to unfold before you.
你可能一开始这个灾难临到的时候，你还不明白。
But the Spirit of glory will rest on you in a way it's not resting on you right now.
但是神的荣耀的灵会住在你身上，是超过你现在有的。
Now Peter knew what he was talking about.
彼得知道他在说什么。
Peter was beaten and thrown in prison a number of times.
彼得被鞭打，被丢在监里很多次。
And history says that he, or tradition says, eventually he was crucified upside down.
那也有历史讲到说彼得是倒挂十架。
Peter was the one that ran in fear when the little servant girl said, "Aren't you a disciple of Christ?"
当那个使女在耶稣受死之后问说，哎，你是跟耶稣的那个人吗？
他是彼得是逃跑的。He says, "If a guy like me can be transformed, so can you."
彼得在说，如果连我都可以被转化的话，你也可以。
In John 17,
约翰福音十七章
at the end of the Last Supper,
在最后的晚餐最后的时候
Jesus said the spirit of glory is coming on you in the end times
他说在末后的时候荣耀的灵要临到你
Now he doesn't connect the glory to martyrdom
他这个荣耀不是只是连于殉道
He talks about martyrdom in chapter 15 and John 15 and 16
他在约翰福音十五十六章里面讲到了殉道
But we don't understand until Peter shows us it's the spirit of glory that comes on the martyrs that God releases in the end time church.
那直到彼得见证这一点，就是神要在末后的教会当中释放这样可以殉道的荣耀。
Paragraph D.
第一点。
Now there's an interesting, I mean, important paradox.
这是一个非常重要的一个概念。
In Revelation 13,
启示录十三章
the Antichrist is going to make war against the saints.
敌基督要跟圣徒征战。
You know, when the popular teaching, it says the saints aren't here when the Antichrist is here.
你知道这个受欢迎的这些教导说。
But I assure you, the saints will be on the earth when the Antichrist is on the earth.
说这个信徒要被提，但是我告诉你，逼迫发生的时候，圣徒还在地上。
It's the very persecution on them that's going God's going to use to bring in the billion soul harvest.
是临到圣徒的逼迫会带领数十亿的人信主。
Well, it will only last for 3.5 years, 42 months.
但是呢，大灾难只会持续三年半的时间，四十二个月。
The Antichrist will overcome the saints physically with martyrdom.
敌基督可能用殉道的方式在肉体上面战胜圣徒。
So the Antichrist overcomes them physically with martyrdom.
所以是敌基督在肉体上面用殉道的方式让圣徒死。
But in Revelation chapter 12,
但是启示录十二章说
the saints overcome Satan spiritually by not being afraid of death.
圣徒在灵里面胜过敌基督是不怕死。
So,The saints are overcome physically by being killed.
所以圣徒在肉身上面被敌基督胜过。
Satan and the Antichrist are overcome spiritually because the saints are fearless in their loyal love to Jesus.
但是呢，圣徒在灵里面却胜过敌基督跟撒旦，因为他们不怕爱耶稣，不怕牺牲生命。
We are fearless because He is the resurrection.
我们不勇敢无畏，是因为耶稣为我们死。
We are sons of the resurrection. We're not afraid of dying.
我们是复活的儿子，我们不怕死亡。
We get to partner with him in the plan to see his Father's glory fill the earth.
我们是在他的计划当中与耶稣同工，直到父神的荣耀充满全地。
The impact of this we will see the benefit of this for billions of years.
这样所带出的益处跟荣耀，我们会永远的看到数十亿的年头。
Paragraph E.
一点。
Now I'll let you read this verse on your own later.
我要让你自己过后再去读。
But Paul says God wants to make His wisdom known through the church.
保罗说我要借着教会彰显我的神的智慧。
He said the demonic principalities will understand God's wisdom when they see it in the church.
说当 借着教会彰显出来的时候，那天上执政掌权的都要看见神的智慧。
And in verse 10, it's a manifold wisdom.
第十节，这是一个百般的智慧。
Meaning there's a number of facets to the wisdom that's going to be revealed to the end time church.
意思就是向末世的教会揭示的这样的智慧有许许多多的层面。
It's like a many-faceted diamond, the wisdom of God's plan.
好像有许多许多层面的这个钻石描述神的智慧。
The principalities and powers.
天上执政掌权的。
That's angels and demons in the supernatural realm.
就是超自然领域当中的天使跟魔鬼。
God has hidden some of this wisdom from them. He hasn't revealed it to them yet.
神还有一些智慧是向他们隐藏的，还没有向他们揭示。
But when the church walks through the end time storyline, that wisdom will be openly displayed to angels and demons.
当教会去经历末世的逼迫的时候，这些智慧要向天上的天使魔鬼。
There's several facets to this wisdom. I'm only going to talk on one of them.
这个神百般的智慧，我们只能讲解一点点。
Paragraph F.
F 点。
Paul said in 1 Corinthians 1.
保罗在哥林多前书一章里讲。
That the message of the cross is foolishness to people's natural mind.
这个十字架的道理对自然人来说显得很愚拙。
How could God have a man be crucified as a criminal to solve the problems of the human race?
神是怎么样用一个人上十字架来解决人类罪性的问题？
It makes no sense.
这一点都没道理。
He's condemned as a criminal.
他被定成罪犯。
He's declared a demonic person by his nation.
他让一个罪人去掌管他的国。
But in that place of on the cross, human history is transformed.
但在十架上，人类的历史被改变了。
He goes because it's God's wisdom to use that to release the power of God into the earthly realm.
保罗说，这是神的智慧要彰显在地上彰显他的荣耀。
Verse 23.
二十三节。
Christ dying in this way.
使基督这样死了
is God's hidden wisdom that nobody understood.
是神那隐藏的智慧是没有人知道的。
Even the apostles at the Last Supper did not see the wisdom of him dying the next day.
甚至使徒在最后的晚餐都没有想到第二天耶稣要上十字架受死。
Verse 25.
二十五节。
But this so-called foolishness of God's plan to use the cross.
但是所谓的这神的计划的这样的愚拙的计划。
It's so-called foolish to the natural mindset.
用人自然的眼光去看，好像很愚拙。
God would use death and bloodshed to bring transformation.
神竟然用流血跟殉道去带出生命的转化。
No, when there's death and bloodshed, that's defeat. That's not transformation and victory.
当流血跟死亡的时候，不是就失败了吗？怎么会有转化呢？
God says, No, it's my hidden wisdom, actually.
神说不，那其实是我隐藏的智慧。
And my hidden wisdom,
那是我隐藏的智慧。
Is viewed by the natural mind as foolishness.
是你的自然的想。
But God, verse 27,
that
God has chosen this so-called foolishness,
神却拣选了那所谓愚拙的
to shame the principalities and powers and the mightiest people of history.
向那历史当中有能力的天上执政掌权的羞愧
He's going to defeat the global antichrist army with believers who bear the cross in their own life.
他会借着那在地上背十架的信徒和教会来得胜敌基督的势力。
Now this wisdom of the cross, obviously Jesus is the foundation of that reality.
当然，对于十字架的这样的智慧，基督就是那根基。
And he had a unique offering in his death on the cross.
他在十字架上受死是一个独特的奉献。
But this same bearing of the cross, the Lord has called the end time church to walk in.
那神也呼召末世的教会以同样的方式去背起自己的十字架。
We don't accomplish redemption or pay for the price of sin for it, of course.
当然我们不是像耶稣一样付上罪的赎价。
But God uses it as a megaphone to shock the nations.And grab their attention to the glory of God.
但是呢，神却用圣徒的流血来抓住列国的注意，让他们看见神的荣耀彰显。
Again, the end time persecution.
在末后的逼迫。
Of the church.
逼迫教会。
Will change the conversation of the entire planet.
会改变全地的对话。
Many believers will be emboldened with power and strength.
许多的信徒会得着一个勇气跟能力。
Many unbelievers will be provoked and convicted and drawn to that kind of heroic love.
许多的不信徒会被说服，会被吸引。 来到这样英勇的爱面前。
Many wicked men will become angry, and they will be drunk with blood, and they will attack in a more fierce way.
许多的罪恶的人呢，会困惑或者是更嗜血，想要来杀害迫害信徒。
Everybody will witness it, and it will be the primary conversation on the planet in those final years.Months before the Lord returns.
每个人都会看见，在基督再来的最后那年日，这会成为地上主要的对话。
Top of page 13.
十三页的最上面。
Roman numeral 5.
第五大点。
Heroic love is awakened most in times of crisis.
在危机的时候，是最能唤醒着英勇的爱。
What does that mean?
这什么意思呢？
Just even in the natural arena.
甚至在自然的领域。
When there is a crisis.
当有危机发生。
There's always a group of people that are awakened to heroic love.
就有许多人好像被唤醒，有一个英勇的爱发出来。
Now there's many responses when a great crisis happens.
当然有很多人会在危机的时候。
Many, when crisis happens, many flee in fear.
那很多人危机发生的时候，他们就逃跑。
Others freeze in indecision; they don't know what to do.
很多人就会愣住了，不知道怎么做决定。
But others arise with this unusual boldness to be helpful.
那很多人他们就会兴起，想要去帮助。
Even when it costs their own life.
即使是付上生命的代价。
I mean, this happens in the human makeup, even apart from.Them being believers.
甚至是在那些非信徒的领域当中，这都是人类很自然的一部分。
Part of the human makeup, the human design.
人类创造的一部分。
God built us this way.
神创造在人里面。
And when the glory of God comes on, it becomes far more powerful.
当神的荣耀临到的时候，就更显出来。
But what do I mean by heroic love is awakened?
那什么叫唤醒英勇的爱？
Many of us have seen the documentaries of 9/11 when the World Trade Center was destroyed.
我们都会看到911的这个纪录片里面，当世贸大厦被炸毁的时候。
September 11, 2001.
2001年9月11号。
The two World Trade Center buildings.
当两个双子大楼的世贸大厦。
Thousands of people are rushing down the stairs.
数千人下楼逃出来。
But The strangest thing happens.
那很奇怪的事就发生。
Hundreds of people are running up the stairs to go be helpful.
有数百的人，他们就往上面跑去救人。
And those that survived,
那些活下来的人
they were asked, "Why did you do it?"
他们就会问说你为什么要那样做
It was something. Well, it's our duty. I'm a fireman.
有的人说啊，我是消防员，这是我的责任。
Well, I'm sure other firemen went the other way.
我也相信有很多消防员是逃跑的。
But others said, "I don't know. It just something came over me. I don't know."
但是有人说，就是我也不知道，我突然就有一个勇气。
I've seen documentaries of this.
我看到有纪录片这样描述。
They're not even saying, "I love Jesus and I did it." Just something came on me. I just had to. I didn't know. I don't know why I did it.
他们不是说哦，因为耶稣在我里面，就是说，哎，我就是有一个勇气，我好像就是想去救人。
We know the examples when a great tsunami or hurricane devastates an area.
我们也看到有地震、海啸发生的时候。
Or a great earthquake.
或者是一个很大的灾难，大地震发生。
Like I remember the earthquake in Haiti in 2010.
我还记得海地2010年发生大地震的时候。
When 250,000 people died.
有。这个二十五万人死亡。
The capital city was devastated, destroyed.
在整个的国家的首都一片的混乱。
And I know from our own ministry in Kansas City.
我们在堪萨斯城的我们的事工。
But 1,000 other ministries.
还有很多数千个其他的事工。
People rush there from all over the world.
很多人从世界各地赶过去救援。
Now I admit.
那我知道。
I stayed home.
我是一个人，我就在家。
But my wife went.
但是我太太去了。
For several weeks.
我太太去救援几个礼拜。
110-degree weather, sweat, everybody in pain everywhere.
110度的天气，哇，各地都有痛苦发生。
It's terrible. I was in air condition. I was calling her on the phone.
我觉得很恐怖，我在吹空调，我在跟她在电话上聊天。
I admit.
我承认。
But she was saying it's remarkable the amount of energy people have to rise up to be helpful.
但是她，我太太见证说。很前所未有看到这么多人去救援，很勇敢。
They were giving all their extra food. They were giving their money. They were giving supplies.
他们是献上自己的钱、精力、他们的时间。
But here's the unusual thing.
但是我告诉你很不一样的。
Thousands of believers were doing this from all over the world.
在全地会有数千的信徒这样做。
And we've seen this in many different crisis zones over the years.
在过去，在很多的灾难当中，我们看到
those very same people.
那同样的人
many of them.
很多
in their neighborhood.
在他们的小区里面
they wouldn't help a neighbor even if the neighbor knocked on their door.
他 邻居在敲门的时候，他们都不会去帮助他们。
I mean, some of them would.
很多人，
有的人会。But many of them just live selfish American lives.
但很多人就会活一个很自私的美国人的生活。
But the crisis awakened something in them. They became sacrificial. Then they went back home and got selfish again.
可是呢，危难发生的时候，他们就突然有勇气去帮助。可是回家之后，就又很闲懒。
Now, obviously, a number of them, they were godly all the way through it.
当然会有很多人是很敬虔的，他们都是一致的。
My point is this.
但我的重点是
there's something about crisis that awakens heroic love in the human heart.
是危机有一个很特别的特性，可以在关键的时候唤醒人心里面的勇力。
Paragraph C.
C 点。
When many Christians read these prophecies of this final 42 months,
当很多基督徒读到这末世42个月的灾难,
they naturally become fearful. They're going, oh no.
他们很自然会害怕，觉得哦。
Well, because they're not experiencing the spirit of glory.
他们没有看见神的极大的荣耀。
They don't have testimonies of loved ones that have experienced the spirit of glory.
他们也没有说所爱的人，他们经历到这样同样的荣耀。
They don't have the biblical narrative of understanding the benefit and the gift that God is giving them in it.
他们可能不明白圣经当中神所应许的这个受苦的得益处。
So standing at a distance is just fearful.
所以他们远远的站着，觉得很害怕。
But when it actually happens,
但是当它真的发生的时候，
God is going to transform the global body of Christ.
神要来转化更新全地的教会。
That is mostly being weighed down with a Laodicean spirit of compromise.
很多人是老底加教会的一个很冷淡的状态。
Some people say there's a billion believers in the earth right now.
有人说在全地有数十亿的基督徒。
I don't know the real number.
我不知道真的数字是什么。
But I think probably 90% of them are weighed down with the Laodicean spirit of dullness in their life.
但我觉得90%的人可能都会被这个老底加的一个冷淡的灵所充满的。
I'm guessing if there's a billion, 800 or 900 million are in that condition.
我相信，如果是有十亿的基督徒的话，或者有一亿或者数千万的基督徒是这样冷淡退后的。
But before the Lord returns,
可是在主再来之前
，the church is radically transformed. These weak people are changed dramatically.
神的教会会被极大的改变，他们会一个英勇的爱会被唤醒。
You read it in the book. It's a victorious church at the end.
你读圣经，你会发现末后将有一个得胜的教会。
Say what happens?
说到底会发生什么
？Lord says, "My leadership, you wait and see. I've got this one."
神说，你等等看看我要怎么做，我的带领。
I'm going to surprise the end-time Laodicean church with that Laodicean spirit, and I'm going to empower them and surprise them.
我会临到那末后的教会，他们现在被老底加的灵充满，但是我要用我的荣耀来充满他们。
In Roman numeral 6,
第六大点。
God is going to use this conflict,
神要使用这个极大的冲突
this bloodshed and persecution,
流血逼迫
with the greatest outpouring of the Holy Spirit,
同时又有圣灵极大的浇灌
and it's going to result in the greatest social miracle of human history,
会成就在人类历史当中社会上最大的神迹
He's going to join the Jews and the Arabs and the Gentiles all together in Christ Jesus,
他会在耶稣里面将犹太人阿拉伯人、外邦人都带到一起。
And he's going to transform the end-time Laodicean spirit into a mature bride.
他要更新带着老底加冷淡的灵的教会进到一个得胜的教会的。
So I don't know all the details in all of our lives.
我不知道我们生命当中每一个细节。
But I know his leadership.
但是我知道他在带领。
And I know the end of the story.
我知道这。
And a lot of times when preachers say we know the end of the story,
很多讲道人会说我们知道故事的结局
They're thinking of Jesus blowing the trumpet in the rapture.
他们就想说啊，耶稣吹号角，我们就被提了。
And yes, we love that.
当然我们喜欢被提。
He will blow the trumpet, and we will be caught up to meet the Lord in the air.
会有吹号声，我们也会在空中与主相遇。
But that's not what I mean by the end of the story.
但是我不是指故事的结局，我不是指这个。
I'm talking about the transformed, mature church that's bold and fearless in power.
我讲的是。那得胜的被更新的教会是充满了勇敢。
Before the trumpet and the rapture, that's the part of the end of the story I'm talking about.
是在被提吹号之前就是这样。
We win not just because we get caught up.
我们要去不是因为我们被提。
Oh, that's my favorite part, of course.
当然这是我最喜欢的部分。
But we win because we choose love across the whole body of Christ, and we mature in our love before Jesus.
我们得胜是因为我们在危机的时 时候能够显明出神的这样的荣耀应有的去爱
you say, Lord, if you can transform fearful Peter, you can transform us as well.
我们说主啊如果你可以更新那个充满害怕的彼得你也可以更新我们
Amen.
Amen.
Let's just stand.
我们一起站立
I'm going to just stand before the Lord for a few moments.
我们就花点时间站在神面前
And we're saying, Lord, teach us.
我们说主啊来教导我们
I mean, I can give this message,
我会讲这个信息
but I'm one of you.
但是我也跟你们一样
I'm going, what? Where's what? What do you mean?
我看到说主啊这什么意思啊
What's that verse mean?
这个经文什么意思
So I'm sitting out there with you as well.
所以我也跟你们坐在那里一样
But I'm confident that the Lord knows what he's doing.
但我相信主知道他在做什么
And in the natural, I don't like some of this stuff.
当然自然人我也不喜欢这个上面写的
But in the spirit, I know there is triumph and the Lord's going to make a way for his people.
可是在灵里面我坚定地相信神要让教会得胜
Just as the worship team's coming,
那敬拜团上来的时候
We're going to worship for a few moments.
我们花一点时间敬拜
I want to advertise a message that I gave about 2 years ago in Kansas City.
我想要来带出一个我两年前在 KC 讲的一个信息很奇怪的
But it's one of the favorite messages that people have told me about.
一个标题是人们很喜欢的我讲的一篇信息
It's a very funny title.
一个很有趣的标题
It's called Why Young Moms Need not be afraid of the great tribulation.
叫做为什么年轻的母亲不需要害怕末世的逼迫
And I gave about 10 or 20 points why a 25-year-old mother doesn't need to be afraid when she thinks of the great tribulation.
我讲了15到20个重点，就是为什么一个25岁年轻的妈妈不用害怕末世的逼迫
And not all the young moms agreed with me, but many of them did.
当然不是每一个妈妈都能够了解跟认同，但是很多人认同。
And the point I'm making in this,
那我的重点就是
is that there's many ideas we have that are wrong ideas about that time.
其实我们认识末世有很多错误的观念。
And I don't understand all the ideas, of course.
当然我也不是知道一切。
But I pointed out a bunch of them and they went, wow, I never even thought about that. I just thought I'd be in a cave with my child starving. That's how I pictured it.
当我讲的时候他们就能够明白说哦我原来以为说逼迫发生的时候我就在山洞里面抱着我受苦的孩子。
That's not how it ends. We don't all end up in caves with our children starving and shivering. That's not how it ends.
不是那样的我们故事的结局不是躲在山洞里面我们都在受饥饿。
Anyway, young dads won't be afraid either.
当然年轻的爸爸们也不会再害怕。
Let's pray.Father, we thank you.
父神，我们感谢你。
Lord, we just trust your leadership.
我们相信你的带领。
We say yes because we trust you.
我们说我们愿意，因为我们信任你的带领。
We say help us, Lord.
主，我们说帮助我们。
In the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣的名。
Just take a couple moments and just talk to him before we just run right out and get into other conversations.
我们花一点时间在我们离开这个房间之前，花点时间来跟神对话。
And then.Tonight, I think it's 7:30. Is that right?
今天晚上七点半
Is that right? 7:30. Yeah, 7:30 tonight. Okay.
今天晚上七点半
So we're just going to talk to the Lord for a few minutes. Just interact with Him.
花点时间跟神对话
Alvin, you're leading worship now. Jesus, we love you. We love you, Jesus.
耶稣，我们爱你。
这是用我的心与你所立的心愿，作为你生命的赎价。爱的火河流进我心，焚烧之灵将我污秽除尽。十架使我们深深连接一起，你的爱情彼此更坚强。我心所爱的极美丽，舍下幼奶并最纯的蜜。你的脚总锁紧指定和地的佳美苏醒人心点燃复兴让我紧握你定恒手跟随你脚步旋转不离
灵眼目发出火焰沸腾我心，我们深渊与深渊相应，我心所爱你极美丽，舍下幼奶并嘴唇的蜜，你的脚踪所经质地何等的佳美，苏醒人心点燃复兴，让我紧握住紧狠手，跟随你脚踪旋转不离，你眼目发出火焰沸腾我心，我们深渊与深渊相映，爱火燃烧，燃烧在我血里，是我为你奋勇征战到底，爱火燃烧，燃烧在我血里，是我一生为你沸腾到底，爱火燃烧，将你烙印我心，是我一生爱你坚贞不移，爱火燃烧，铭刻在我心里，与你今生相约，见面在永恒。爱火燃烧，燃烧在我血里，是我为你奋勇征战到底，爱火燃烧，燃烧在我血里，是我一生为你沸腾到底，爱火燃烧，将你烙印我心，是我一生爱你坚贞不移，爱火燃烧，铭刻在我血里，与你今生相约，见面在永恒。爱火燃烧，燃烧在我血里，是我为你奋勇征战到底，爱火燃烧，燃烧在我血里，是我一生为你沸腾到底，爱火燃烧，将你烙印我心，是我一生爱你坚贞不移，爱火燃烧，铭刻在我心里，与你今生相约，
烧在我心，燃烧。
住你的手，使我将生命倾注于你，这是用我的血与你所立的心愿，作为你生命的赎价，爱的过河流进我心，焚烧之灵将我污秽赎净，释迦使我们深深连接一起，你的爱情比死更坚强，爱的火河流进我心，焚烧之灵将我污秽除净，释迦使我们深深连接一起，你的爱情比死更坚强，爱的火河流进我心，焚烧之灵将我污秽除净，释迦使我们深深连接一起，你的爱情比死更坚强。Jesus, we want to know you. We want to know the fellowship of your suffering, to be joined to your cross. Give us the grace. For your love is stronger than death. 也是我们渴望认识你。我们渴望认识，甚至效法你的死。让十架使我们连结在一起。因你爱情比死更坚强。